Welcome to Fly TV. You got Ivan, Keanu, and myself, Gibo.
Hello.
Yeah, welcome to Fly TV. And don't forget to follow us on our social media accounts at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at FlyFM958.
That's right. You can also tune in to us in the Klang Valley 95.8 FM, or you can download the app for your smartphone and take us wherever you go. So what are we talking about today, Keanu?
We are going to talk about something that breaks my heart all the time, which is about exes.
Well, why does your ex still break your heart, though? Mm. How long has it been?
I haven't moved on. I have a hard time moving on, okay?
Okay, but how long has it been?
A year.
That's bad.
I mean,
are you still friends with on her? Do you follow still hard on her Instagram?
I follow them all, but
what?
Don't associate.
You mean you're keeping track of all your exes?
Kind of.
Friends on Facebook?
Don't you guys do that? Do you guys just cut ties with your exes?
No, I don't cut ties. But we're still friends and whatever, but we move on. Look, dude, you're sitting next to the guy who's literally the master of moving on.
Oh, really?
The master.
I don't know about that.
So he helps other people move on.
Actually, move on fully by not even talking to your exes, or do you move on peacefully by actually just normally connecting to them?
Not talking to them. That's the best way to move on.
And it doesn't hurt you at all?
It hurts a little bit, but I mean, after an hour or so, you get to move
on.
After an hour?
After 1 year, not yet move on yet. If after Listen, 1 hour, can move on.
But it's because you still follow them on social media and you're still friends with them on Facebook.
Kinda.
That's a bad thing.
That's like one way to do it, though. I feel like for me, what really helped me move on is you gotta get through the hard part of the breakup. I think a lot of couples, like when they break up, they don't have that conversation as to why everything.
That's true.
You need the closure.
You need closure. Exactly. And, conversations are so important.
It's because you're so worried about the uncomfortable conversation. You know what I mean? Mm. It's like difficult to have the conversation.
But it's necessary.
It is. It's 100%. I think that helped me move on a lot because I know that I've left no questions unanswered.
Yeah.
Whatever. So I think that helps.
The reason why I have not moved on fully is because we never actually had a conversation.
Exactly. It's just like okay, bye, and then like.
So what? You fought, and then that's it.
Fought, and then she chose to not talk to me again, and I was like, okay lah, I mean, what am I gonna do? And then I just like, you know, for one whole year I was just like this. But I'm fine now, guys. I'm fine now.
Sure.
It's just
sure. You just sniffed and
trying to be fine. But honestly speaking, I do believe that it's totally fine to be friends with your exes. I mean, why should you make things complicated? Why should you make things awkward? Especially that sometimes your exes could be your workmate or your schoolmate. Because my ex was in my college, guys, in my class. So I had to see her for the whole semester. Thank God it was only the last semester.
But was this okay? Say this chica of yours, right?
Okay.
What if she was your first love? If she was your first love and you still remain friends until this day,
then feelings could eventually come back.
Maybe, I don't know. It could happen to some people.
Well, the way I look at it is this. The reason why you got with the person in the first place is because that person is awesome. And you guys had a good relationship going on. So even though you break up, it doesn't change the fact that this ex of yours is still an awesome person. So
correct.
If you want to have an extra awesome friend, you would obviously want to keep them as your friend. Now, of course, it's difficult. You know, you're going to have to deal with the possibility of remission and all that stuff. But, you know, I value a person too much for me to want to just cut ties with them. But, you know, it's not up to me. Both parties have got to agree on it. So if my ex doesn't want to be friends with me, then it's just too bad, really.
That's true.
That's right. In fact, you guys can share what you guys think about this on our social media at Facebook or Twitter or Instagram at FlyFM958. But before that, here is today's hottest music.
To look back at all the messages you'd sent.
And I Aisha, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. Cause I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you always, JT.
Cause girls like you run around with guys like me till sundown. When I come through, I need a girl like you, yeah, yeah. Girls like you love fun and yeah, me.
She used to meet me on the inside in the city with a sun on set. And every day you know that we ride through the back streets of a blue Corvette. Baby, you know I just wanna leave tonight.
This week on FlyBuzz, we want to talk about film scenes that were initially not in the script but were put in the film anyway. Number one, The Devil Wears Prada. Remember the scene where Anne Hathaway and Meryl Streep had a serious conversation in the hotel room? Meryl Streep was seen not wearing any makeup. Did you guys know that it was actually Meryl Streep's idea to not have any makeup on? Meryl wanted to make the scene very realistic because she was telling about how her life was in shambles, her marriage, her career, and that definitely did the trick because that scene had such a big impact on people and it went on to become one of the best film scenes in movie history. Next up, we've got The Shining. Who doesn't know how iconic Jack Nicholson is? And speaking of iconic, The Shining was known for one scene in which Jack Nicholson went through a hole in the door saying, "Here's Johnny!" That scene was initially not even in the script, but Jack Nicholson was a genius enough to think of that scene and it went on to become such an iconic and legendary scene. Next up, we've got the first installment of Spider-Man. Remember the scene where Tobey Maguire was trying out his spiderweb skills on a rooftop? Well, yet again, that was actually not in the script, but Tobey Maguire was such a genius to think of that idea. Well then, now, who could ever forget the scene, right?
Shazam! Go! Go! Go, Web, go!
Next up is Rocky Balboa in 1976. So there was a scene where Rocky was running through a market and little did you guys know that actually that was an actual market and none of the people there were actually paid actors. The scene was so real that there was one stall hawker who threw an orange to Rocky and he took it and said thank you and even that made it into the movie. Last but not least, The Dark Knight Rises. There was a scene in The Dark Knight Rises where Heath Ledger, who played the Joker, was dressed in a nurse attire and he was supposed to press the detonator to blow up the hospital. It was supposed to only take one hit on the detonator to hit the explosion, but then again, it didn't work for some reason. Keith had to actually press it several times and boom, it finally worked. But then he was caught off guard and he ran into the bus. That scene made it into the movie and is currently one of the most iconic scenes in film history. Subscribe to Fly TV and press the bell for latest updates.
Welcome back to Fly TV. You got Ivan, Keanu, and myself, Kipo.
That's right. We've just gotten past National Day. We've just gotten past Malaysia Day as well.
Yep.
They're basically reminders of how happy we are to be Malaysians, how proud we are to be Malaysians.
Yes, and it's reminding us of the so many things that we love about Malaysia.
Mm-hmm, you know, but it's so easy to say like, I love everything about Malaysia, but I'm going to put you guys on the spot.
Fine.
Three of your top things, three of your favorite things about Malaysia. You got to come up with it right now. I'll give you a moment to think.
Three is very hard. Let's go number one for me. Beaches.
Number one.
We have beautiful beaches.
Beaches, mama. And I think my number one is going to be the food, full stop, and a story. I'm not going to pick one food, it's all food. Like, everything is good in Malaysia.
That's true. You got nasi lemak, nasi kerabu, keropok leko. Mm-hmm.
Segala nasi dalam dunia dekat Malaysia ni.
Yeah.
Okay, and now the second item is Malaysia.
Diversity.
Diversity.
We're very multicultural.
Spoken like a true politician.
Right? It's true, though. It's true. That's what makes our food so great.
That's right.
I think I like the public transport in Malaysia, I think, because I like to commute via LRT and I can go everywhere.
It's because you want to meet the ladies. That's why you're a little creeper.
That's why you
can't meet ladies when you're in your own car, right?
I don't even know.
A lot of ladies in a coach, so,
My God. That's why they have their own ladies' own coach.
Thanks for nothing, Ibo.
Ladies only parking way for
Kiatu.
To stop him from creeping.
That's why.
My second favorite thing about Malaysia has got to be similar to diversity and similar to that as well. It's actually the ladies. I think our Malaysian ladies are beautiful.
They are.
And it's always nice, you know, to go on and have a beautiful lady.
Very, very nice. And it's tough because we have so many things. It's tough to narrow down just three.
This is why like road accidents happen all the time, man. Because there's just too many distractions.
Takes a look around.
It's because you're bending your neck, right? You're like this.
Exactly. Like, what? Okay. Third thing.
Man, this is tough.
Yeah, it's tough. I know.
It's just, all right, we've already done food, tourist spots. What else?
I got mine. You know what? I'll go first on the third one. I love the nightlife.
The thing about
KL and Malaysia in general, that just, we just don't go to bed, man. Like, something's open for you all day, every day, so you can just go out, grab food, go out, you know, just have fun with friends and stuff.
There's
so many things going on.
People say that the money never sleeps, but KL people never sleep.
Yeah, no, for real. Yeah. Awesome. I love it.
That's true.
I don't know, like, what's my third thing. Like, Gibo said, there's too many things about Malaysia to love.
stuff. Okay, wait. Okay, let me.
Help me out.
Okay, let me. This is. I'm gonna pinpoint some cities. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Penang.
Yeah.
Love Penang. Mm-hmm. Love Melaka.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because they preserve the heritage sites over there. That's one thing I like about Malaysia.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I think there's two sides of Malaysia. That's the modern side, and there's also the historic side, and that's why there's a lot to explore about the country. So that's one thing I really like about the country. Actually. Mm. What's your last one?
I just did.
Oh, you went already?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was just so caught up thinking about what I love about Malaysia. But honestly though, can I just like strengthen my point about mama? Because honestly, without mama, I don't know what to do malam-malam. I'm a
good mama. Are you saying mama or mama?
Mama with a K.
Yeah, dude.
With a K in the back, okay.
Okay.
I love the mama life so much.
Well, since he's picked his favorite thing.
Oh my God, I have one more to say about Malaysia.
Okay.
I love so much.
Yeah.
Sorry, eh? Mm. I forgot one.
Yeah, go.
I was like, I asked for three. You get four.
But to give the fourth one before you do, you have to eliminate one before.
Fine.
Yeah.
What are you going to get rid of?
The
mama?
Fine, the public transport.
I knew it! I knew it!
You're on about public transport.
I knew it.
I can live without public transport.
Sure you can.
But I cannot live without teh tarik.
Mm.
Yes! Teh tarik!
But that goes under food.
No.
Yeah, isn't that mama?
Specifically teh tarik.
So isn't mama and teh tarik the same thing?
No, not necessarily. You can have teh tarik at home. My mom does the best teh tarik, guys. Also, little trivia, guys. Since we're talking about Malaysia.
Yeah.
Honestly, I feel like I baru jadi Malaysian last year.
Why?
Because that was the first year I went to mama, the first year I had teh tarik. Yes!
How old are you?
I'm 21 and I started doing these things when I was 20.
Do you need a license to do this or what?
It felt like I did.
You went to the mama a year ago?
A year ago.
Where did you go before?
Yeah, exactly.
That's
where you went.
10 p.m. I'll be in bed. That's how un-Malaysian I was, guys.
I don't know what just happened.
No one knows how to react.
I think I went to the mama when I was like 6 or something.
How?
I think I went to the mama when I was an infant.
You know, prior to last year, every time I see people at the mama, I'm like, your parents don't question.
So wait, you never had roti canai or anything?
No lah, for breakfast, smoke enough, but the nightlife mama kind of thing, like lepak culture.
Mm-mm.
You know what, you guys, if you see Keanu outside, just drag him to the mama because he obviously needs a social life. He needs to meet some people as well.
Yeah,
help him out, alright?
Please.
In the meantime, a parody from 5M's Hafiz and Gibo. Why don't you tell us about this one, man?
So, in conjunction with National Day and also Malaysia Day, we want to kind of give back to Malaysia because there's so many great things that we all love about Malaysia.
Yeah, yeah.
And we did a parody of Cardi B's I Like It Like That, but it's more like I Like Malaysia Like That.
Woo! Let's check it out.
Take them pictures. I like tropical fields. Where's my fan, bro? I'm sweating. Jom pergi tugu negara ni atas perdana. I like going to the mama. Tak kisah pukul berapa. I got kawan from Oasis and they all love to dance. They look very pretty in their traditional garment. I call them Maggie, Illy, Lakshmi, Siti, Sini, Becky. Very pretty. Every Sunday we buggy banana leaf with curry. Hotter than soup, standing in queue. Ane tambah nasi satu. From a can, Malaysian food, we are the champ. We adore nasi campur. Chili potong must have, bro. I ate so much, not lucky. Burn the fast like cardio. Put a country on the map. I like Malaysia like that. Kinabalu to Merced. I like Malaysia like that. We got Yuna, she can say. I like Malaysia like that.
Oh, he's so handsome, what's his name?
Oh my God, it's Henry Golding.
All year in the summer.
I like Malaysia like that.
We complain it's fine.
We sangat suka. Different races, yo, all fused to one beautiful culture.
Got invites for rumah terbuka. Celebrate all the cuti di Bavali, CNY Hari Raya.
Hari Gawa in Sarawak untuk dadau in Sabah.
Mama Malaysia, I love my negara.
Oh, he's so handsome, what's his name?
Oh my God,
Welcome back to Fly TV, everybody, with us both very obedient students and our cikgu yang kononnya selalu membantu dengan bahasa Malaysia kita. Cikgu.
You know what? You know what? I recognize the effort, okay? I really do. I understand he's trying to educate us, all right? So we shouldn't be too hard.
You know, respecting
our they're very bitter and sour because they actually don't know the words. That's the best part. I teach them a new word and then they get frustrated because they don't know.
Mari kita mula.
So you know what? Let's kick things off with a little easier words.
Hey, thank you.
Okay.
This is a solid figure right here.
Okay, this is easy, okay?
Alright.
Masa hari jadi.
Okay.
You akan dapat apa?
Hadiah.
Hadiah dalam bahasa Inggeris apa?
Present!
There you go. See? It's easy.
What? Just like that?
I think we improve our BM community.
Definitely.
We got better.
Okay, what about this? Masa hari jadi, ada balloon, ada lilin, ada kek, ada sparklers, ada confetti. Semua benda ni apa? Kita nak buat bilik
dekorasi.
Decoration dalam bahasa Malaysia apa?
Penghiasan. Penghiasan.
Hias-hias.
Apa?
Hiasan.
Hiasan.
Perhiasan.
Perhiasan.
Bagi pasal apa?
You said apa? Dekorasi.
Eh, also kau so I think you check first.
Okay.
Sinonim, okay?
Okay, sure. Okay, let's move up to the big leagues now. Okay.
Right,
let's
bring out the big guns.
Let's go. Okay. Kalau ada selebriti datang di Malaysia.
Okay. Paparazzi.
Okay, yeah.
Pergi ke airport.
Okay, kalau selebriti
PRA.
Okay, kalau selebriti ni musician. Okay, dia nak buat konsert. Sebelum konsert, dia nak menjumpa media.
Okay. Sidang akbar.
Sidang media lah.
Sidang media.
Media.
Sidang
akbar. Media.
I haven't got it right.
What?
Sidang akbar in English is
press conference.
Kiara's really bad.
You know what? He wants to take credit for it.
I know.
That's hoping that no one realizes.
He's trying to take credit for it, but it's okay. I got it.
Sidang media is
pretty good, huh?
Sidang media
pretty good.
Pretty good, huh?
Ivan's pretty good.
You know what? I give credit to you. You, man. Tell me everything, man.
Tapi I still dapat betul yang sinonim punya tau. This is not on point lah.
Not on point. You want another one, right?
Yeah. One more. Let's do one more.
One more. Okay, one more. Let's do this one. Okay, this. Okay, this should be really super easy. Kalau kita pakai suit,
panas.
Ya, memang panas.
Kemeja, kemeja.
Okay, kemeja. Okay, kalau kita pakai, is there a word for suit in bahasa Malaysia?
Is there?
Tak tahu. Jacket.
Suit.
Jacket.
S-U-T suit.
Okay, kalau kita pakai suit kan?
Ajalah.
Kita nak pergi wedding
betul,
is perkahwinan. Okay, kita akan kena pakai benda ni dekat kita punya baju. Apa benda ni?
Ini tali leher.
Yes, dalam bahasa Inggeris?
Necktie.
Good job. She finally got one.
Finally,
good.
I can take credit for something I actually said.
Yeah, that's pretty good. All right. Well, we did pretty okay. How would you do out there though? Well, we took the cup of summer gibbons to the street. So let's find out.
So, I'm going to try to teach you guys a new word in Bahasa Malaysia. Let's go, okay?
He is going to try his best to explain the word and we have to guess the BM. Okay, so right now we got Hurley and Faith. They say their BM sucks, but actually their BM is way better than Gibo's.
I think so.
So, anda bersedia?
Kalau kita guna pen, dalam pen tu ada isi kan? Pen ni dalam isi dia apa?
Ink
dalam bahasa Malaysia apa? Ink dalam bahasa Malaysia apa? Nama isi dia apa?
Tinta. Bukan.
Tadi kamu cakap apa?
Itu bahasa Indonesia.
Tinta nama macam ex-girlfriend saya.
No, this one is easy. This one is easy.
You got this.
But I don't know.
It's in the back of your head.
I forgot this, man.
Oh, come on.
Pen punya isi itu apa?
Dakwat.
Dakwat dalam bahasa Inggeris?
Ink.
Yeah. It sounds like an animal. The first syllable. The second syllable is what Lil Jon loves to say.
Dakwat.
Dakwat.
What's an octopus in Malay?
Octopus?
No, not octopus.
Sotong?
Sotong. No.
Dakwat.
Yes!
You Googled it. You Googled it.
What about the D? It starts with D, right? Dakwat.
Yeah!
That's what Lil Jon loves to say.
What?
Alright, so we got Ryan and Nav here. Alright, let's go.
Ryan and Nav. Kalau kita nak call orang tapi tak ada cell phone, kita guna apa?
Kita guna ni kalau kita tak ada line dekat rumah.
Telefon ni guna coin. Phone ni boleh jumpa dekat mall, boleh jumpa dekat hospital.
Tepi-tepi jalan itu, Min?
Ya.
Telefon rumah mah? Apa? Telefon umum ah?
Public phone lah.
Public phone dalam bahasa Malaysia apa?
Payphone,
public phone dalam bahasa Malaysia apa?
Public good.
Ya, what is it in PM?
Telefon public lah.
Telefon awam.
Sorry, telefon awam. Telefon awam.
Yes.
Telefon bimbit. Telefon awam.
Bimbit ke iPhone?
Awam.
Super.
Telefon awam.
Yes.
What do I get?
You get this. Nah. Yeah.
Very funny, Cikgu Gibo. Very funny.
I'm not trying to be. I'm trying to educate the mass.
No, you're not.
Educating, really.
No, you're not. There's no worse teacher in the world than Cikgu Gibo right there.
You guys didn't even know how to
But we've got to give him a chance. You know, he might improve over the next couple of weeks. But speaking of which, if you're wondering why we suddenly turned up with some, you know, party stuff, presents and hats and stuff, it's our birthday!
Yes! And at Fly FM, we are doing things very differently. We're not asking for presents from you guys, lah. Just because we turn old doesn't mean we need presents from you guys, because we are giving you guys presents.
That's right. It's Fly's birthday bash, and we're celebrating you all day, every day. So you gotta tune in. Yo, I mean, I heard you guys gave out some really good stuff.
Yes. Okay, so in the mornings, we unboxed one gift, and that gift was worth over 5,000 ringgit. Can you guess as to what it was?
Oh my God, was it a laptop?
A camera?
It was an iPhone 10.
What?
I want it.
We don't even have that. I don't have it. You don't have it.
No.
And we're not even qualified to join. It's just you guys, not us.
Wow.
What did you give out?
I've given out a pair of speakers. I've given out some tickets to some great experiences. Mm-hmm. You know, it's going to be very exciting because I can only imagine that the gifts will get bigger from now. You know what I mean?
Pretty much. And the best part is, if you missed out on Hafs and Gibo show, it's okay. You got Maggie.
Mm-hmm. You got Ivan.
Yeah. And then you also got
Ely.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So it's like four times a day we give you a present. Mm-hmm. All you got to do is join us on Instagram Live at FlyFM958. So here's how it works. Even we don't know what in these boxes. Yeah, even we don't know what we're giving you, but on Instagram Live, we unwrap the presents together, so we find out together, and then you get to walk away with the present if you call us at 0377241144.
Yep.
In fact, I heard that we are giving away 100 presents in total.
Wow.
That's a lot of presents.
That's a lot. That's 100 people who get presents even though it's not their birthday, it's ours.
Like, it's our birthday. I mean, wow. I've never heard this before.
Mm-hmm.
So your birthday giving away people stuff? That's cool. So you guys are in line to win exciting prizes as well, and it gets bigger and bigger every time. So, you know the drill. You got this.
All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching Fly TV. Now, remember, if you want to watch this episode again, you can check it out at youtube.flyfm.com.my and on tonton.com.my as well.
Yes. And also, make sure you follow us on social media. Twitter, Insta. That's FlyFM958. Also, what's our Facebook?
Facebook.com/FlyFM. Check it out. See you guys next week on Fly TV. Bye.